It's easy to pick up the general trends for the new season, but that could leave you looking like everyone else. A touch of ethnicity can set you apart from the crowd. We chatted to fashion blogger Yuthika Nagessur to get some tips on how to do it.
Yuthika had suggested to Madhushan Singh that they meet at one of her favorite venues.
Spring is in the air, which means our wardrobe is in need of a makeover. Fortunately, today I meet fashion blogger and style icon Yuthika Nagessur, and she's going to take us through her spring line.
A pharmacist by profession, Yuthika also dispenses style tips that are trendy yet original.
Hello, Yuthika.
Hi, Madhushan. How are you?
Good, and yourself?
Good, thanks.
Thank you so much for joining us on Mela today. This place is amazing. How did you find this location?
Well, Durban is quite a small little city, and I actually stumbled across this place with a few friends and instantly fell in love.
What made you choose this venue for today?
It's such a multi-dimensional atmosphere, and it's got such a cool vibe. Each wall has a different feel, a different idea behind it, and it really inspires me. So I love to come here to write, you know, to think, to create, and to put my blog pieces together.
Now, you're the brains behind the blog Be Youthful. How do you sum it up in one sentence?
To me, Be Youthful is a blog that empowers young women to embrace their individuality. It really encourages one to be young, be beautiful, and to most importantly, be themselves. It does take a lot of work, and working full time, you know, it also requires balance. Doing it allows me to release my creative juices, so I would never stop.
Well, I'm very excited to see your spring line, so let's go have a look.
Yeah, let's go.
So Yuthika, tell me, from a fashion perspective, what does spring mean to you?
It actually reminds me of spring in India, where Holi is celebrated, and there's just an array of color and beautiful things coming together. So that's where I draw my inspiration from for spring. For spring, embroidery is really in. So we're taking embroidery in with us from winter into spring. So it's a cool transition piece. And we also have this, which is an embroidered jumper, which is really nice because the florals come through. And I actually think that embroidery is replacing the patchwork trend that we saw in winter, because it's more organic, it's more airy, it's very fresh. And we're actually seeing embroidery nowadays on everything, from caps to shirts to shoes. So that's a really good trend that I'm really loving. Another trend that's very big for spring are sleeves. So the more drama on the sleeves, the better. We're seeing big sleeves this season, tiered sleeves, balloon sleeves, bell sleeves. It's all about the ruffles and the truffles, and yeah, so that's really big this season as well. Here we can see two trends being combined into one piece. So here we have a gingham print, which is an old print that's really made a very big comeback for the spring in all colors. And the spring here, we can see a tiered sleeve. And yeah, it really works well together.
So this is one of the pieces that caught my eye when I walked in. Tell me about this one.
When it comes to pieces like this, and whenever I come across an Indian piece that's classic, I like to invest in it. So if you look at these specific waistcoats, they're so versatile because they're different colors. The embroidery is so beautiful. You can wear it over jeans, over dresses, over tops. And it just adds that Indian touch. So when it's Heritage Month and you're looking to add a bit of your Indian heritage into your, maybe you're going to work, your workwear, or even just going out, this is a really good idea. Or we can also incorporate things like scarves, so beautiful embroidery like this, or even earrings and bangles, and that's a good way to incorporate an Indian heritage into your everyday wear.
Well, one of the festivals that we do celebrate is, of course, the festival of Navratri. How do you bring that into this?
Well, when I think of Navratri, I think of celebration, I think of dancing, lots of garba. So if you're looking for something different this year and something innovative and, you know, something really cool, would be something different like this, and which is a lehenga skirt, but it's actually something that I had made. So what I did was I got a blouse piece and used that as a waistband. Also creating a slit in the skirt, which is really good for when you're dancing and you're twirling, gives you extra movement, and it's really nice like that. And then to add that little extra Indian touch, we stuck little mirrors on the outside. So, you know, to get creative, making your own garments, and then this is really fun for dancing, allows you to be a bit more modern, but also embrace traditional wear. denim is definitely a go-to, and people often shy away from denim because they think it's mostly for winter, but for me it's definitely a piece that can be worn throughout season, because nowadays we're seeing denim that's reworked, so it involves mesh, fishnets, it's quite airy, it's quite fresh, it's quite free. And for me, this is a really cool piece because it's distressed denim, but it's also personalized. So now if you see something like this, I'm all about pieces that are unique and individual, that celebrate your individuality. When someone sees this on you, they'll instantly know the kind of person that you are. And this is really cool because it's creative, it's a chance to get, you know, expressive with your clothing. So this is really nice. And then we also have a denim dress, which incorporates all the trends in one. It's got the sleeves, it's got the embroidery, it's got stunning sequins, and it is denim. So that's a beautiful dress for spring, something like this. Another thing that's really cool, especially when transitioning between seasons, so if we're going from winter into spring, are jumpsuits. And personally, I love jumpsuits because who doesn't love a socially acceptable onesie? And this jumpsuit's really nice. It's got a culotte pants, which are also really in. These wide-legged pants are nice and comfortable. And layering during this transitional phase is really nice as well. You can put a nice collared shirt over and tie it up here, which creates a nice look. Or you can wear it with a polar neck or a turtleneck underneath for those colder nights.
How would you accessorize with these outfits?
For me, accessories are something that really ties the outfit together. So from shoes to earrings to bags, that's what is really important about a look. For example, I love these shoes. They're jutis, which are traditional Indian footwear. But what's really nice about these is that they actually have vintage painted cameras on them, which gives them a modern feel, gives them a fun, quirky feel. Then of course, we have earrings. Tassels are really in. At the moment, so nice springy colors are really nice to wear for your earrings. And then when it comes to bags, you can look at nice embroidered bags, and the embroidery is actually going through, as I said earlier, all the way from clothing to footwear. So we can see this coming through really nicely this spring, and it incorporates the florals, which is really nice. And then also, I love hats, so that's one of my favorite things to do, from berets to these beautiful hats like this. I really like things like this, which in my opinion tie the outfit together.
Yuthika, you've taken us through your fashion line. I cannot wait to see how you mix and match it and how it looks when it's all put together.
Yeah, let's do it.
The jumpsuit onesie created a striking silhouette while also offering a neutral backdrop to multicolored waistcoat. Channeling the 70s, a floral print on cool summer white. Flower power gives classic denim a boost, complemented by gingham geometry.
Yuthika, that was amazing.
Thank you.
I just want to ask you, what's your final thoughts to all the fashion bloggers at home?
Well, I would say if you have a passion, then follow your heart. Being fulfilled is really important in life. Here I am, I'm a pharmacist, but I'm just following my creativity and letting that take me where it does. So yeah, I would just say follow your heart.